सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सहवीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। नमः श्री शंकरानंद नमः श्री शंकरानंद गुरुपादाम्बुजन्मने गुरुपादाम्बुजन्मने सविलास महामोह सविलास महामोह ग्राहग्रासैककर्मणे ग्राहग्रासैककर्मणे। And now we go to the 15th and the last chapter, or the 5th chapter of this section. Brahmanande Vishayananda Nama Panchamodhyaya. The 5th chapter is about Vishayananda, interesting. So, in this section called Brahmananda, the 5th chapter is Vishayananda. First was Yogananda, second was Atmananda, third was Advaitananda, fourth was Vidyananda. The fifth is Vishayananda. Ananda, first is Yogananda. The ananda, the joy that comes by yoga, union between the self and Brahman. Meaning, due to abidance of the self, abidance of the mind of the self. Atmananda, the ananda that arises because of Atma. Meaning, knowing the self as non-dual. Advaitananda, also the ananda that arises in knowing Brahman or ananda as non-dual. Vidyananda, the ananda arises as a result of knowing Atma as Brahma. Vishayananda, which all, they were all fine. But now in the 15th chapter, the last chapter, though also it discusses Vishayananda, the ananda of the happiness that arises as a result of the experience of sense objects. So that ananda he describes here. Panchamadhyasya Pratipadim Arsamaha. So in the very first verse, the author tells us, what is it that is to be expounded in this fifth or the 15th chapter, says the first verse.
Athatra Vishayanandaha Athatra Vishayanandaha Brahmanandam Sharupabhag Brahmanandam Sharupabhag निरूप्यते द्वारभूतः निरूप्यते द्वारभूतः तदंशत्वं श्रुतिर्जगौ तदंशत्वं श्रुतिर्जगौ। असत्र विषयानंदः ब्रह्मानंद अंशरूपभाग। अत्र हियर विषयानंदः। नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्क्राइब विषयानंद, the ananda or the happiness that comes by experience of Vishaya, the sense objects. Why is it so? Why are you doing it? So, Vishayananda nirupyate. Athatra Vishayananda nirupyate. That now in this last chapter, he has expounded the subject matter of Vishayananda, the ananda or the happiness that comes as a result of experience of Vishaya or the sense objects. Nanu Vishayanandasya Laukikatvat Moksha Shastre Nirupanam Anupannam. Somebody asks him, so hey, this Panchadashi is Moksha Shastra. Panchadashi is a text or a scripture which expounds Moksha, which is a means of Moksha or liberation. Vishayanandasya Laukikatvat. But then Vishayananda, or the happiness of the sense objects, is laukika, meaning it is samsarika. It is not moksha, it is something extrovert. And therefore, it is something that causes bondage. So what is the need for discussion of that? Nirupanam anupannam. Therefore, the discussion of the Vishayananda, or the happiness from the sense objects, doesn't seem to be appropriate in the text which is devoted to the exposition of moksha, liberation. So what relevance does this have with moksha? Tasya laukika prasiddhatvepi. Author says, yeah, you're right. Right? This Vishayananda meaning
the happiness of the objects is, no doubt, is laukika. Meaning, it is extrovert. It is not something that is conducive to moksha. Still, we want to study that. Why? Because study of that ananda also is brahmananda ikadeshatvena brahmajnana upayogitvat. Since even that ananda or happiness that comes by experience of sense objects is also what? Nothing but a fraction of brahmananda. Brahmanandam sarubhak. As we said, brahmananda, ananda, that is brahman, is comparable to ocean. And ananda that is experienced through any sense object is comparable to a drop in the ocean. So why are you studying the drop? Because drop also is a fraction of the ocean. So study of the drop also enables us to understand the ocean well, you know. Inasmuch as ananda or happiness experienced anywhere is nothing but the experience of Brahman, wherein in this case the sense object becomes a means for revealing the Brahman, the self. So the ananda of the self, which remains obscured, or which remains veiled or concealed because of the mind being sad or grieving or whatever, dull or agitated. So when the mind is like that, we are not experiencing happiness of our own self, and what the sense object does is, it just becomes a nimitta, becomes an occasion, becomes instrumental in clearing that mind momentarily, and the ananda or happiness that is experienced is nothing but the happiness of Brahma. But still, depending upon the clarity of this antahkarana, the clarity of our own mind, the intensity of that ananda is proportional to the clarity. Clear the mind is, greater is the joy even for a sense object. Anyway, sense object, for some reason, able to clear mind completely, you experience from ecstasy. So that also you can have, depending upon how clear the mind becomes. So idea is that the happiness that is experienced as a result of a sense object also is nothing but a fraction of the same Brahmananda. Because Brahma is the only source of ananda. So even the Vishayananda or the happiness of sense objects also, the source is nothing but Brahman. And so it is said, Brahma jnana upayogitva. And therefore, even study of this ananda, the sensuous pleasure, even study of that also becomes helpful, becomes useful in gaining the knowledge of Brahmananda. So it is a dvarabhutaha, because it is dvarabhutaha. Dvara means a door. So it becomes a door, becomes a means for understanding and knowing Brahmananda. That is the reason why we want to study that. So as you said, as Kinopanishad says, pratibodha viditam matam. Brahman is known with reference to every thought. Thought is not Brahman, but every thought reveals Brahman. Because every thought is based in the light of consciousness. Every thought therefore reflects consciousness. And that's how even a thought also becomes a dwara, or a gate, or a means for knowing Brahman. For example, a mirror is not my face, but mirror becomes a gate to reveal my face. And similarly also, the Vishayananda is not Brahmananda, but Vishayananda becomes a gate or a means for knowing Brahmananda. But how do you say that the ananda that is gained from Vishaya of the sense objects is a fraction of Brahmananda? How do you say that? Brahmananda ikadeshatve kim pramanam? So where do you get this idea that the ananda experienced in Vishayas also is a fraction of Brahmananda? Says the verse, tadamsatvam shrutir jagau. That Vishayananda is an amsa or a fraction of Brahmananda is what Shruti of the Upanishad herself says. So Upanishad itself says that the happiness experienced, even the sense objects, is a fraction of the happiness of Brahman alone, happiness that is Brahman alone. Tameva Shrutim asrath pashati. And that statement from Brihadaranyaka, which says that any ananda experienced anywhere is a fraction of Brahmananda, that Shruti is explained here, quoted here, not verbatim, but then by meaning. So meaning of that statement or passage from Brihadaranyaka Upanishad is given in the second verse.
एशोस्य परमानंदः एशोस्य परमानंदः यो खंडैकरसात्मकः यो खंडैकरसात्मकः अन्यानि भूतान्येतस्य अन्यानि भूतान्येतस्य मात्रामेवोपभुञ्जते मात्रामेवोपभुञ्जते एषहस्य परमानंदः सेज बृहदारण्यकोपनिषद् दिस ब्रह्मानंद इज परमानंद सेज एषास्य परमागतिः एषास्य परमा संपदा एषहस्य परमो लोकः एषहस्य परम आनंदः सेज बृहदारण्यकोपनिषद् एषास्य परमागतिः दिस ब्रह्मानंद इज द अल्टीमेट गति द अल्टीमेट गोल ऑफ दिस पर्सन ब्रह्मानंद इज the ultimate goal, even the happiness that is experienced in deep sleep also is Brahmananda. So I am referring to that, referring to the ananda or the happiness that is experienced in the state of deep sleep, which is Brahmananda, says Brihadaranyaka Upanishad, esha asya paramagati. For this jiva, for this individual, for this being, this Brahmananda is a paramagati. He is the ultimate gati, ultimate end. Esha asya Paramasampada. This is the greatest of the wealth. So this is the greatest of the wealth or accomplishment for this person, for any individual. Eshasya paramolokaha. This is the paramalokaha. See, the most exalted region that anybody may want to accomplish. Eshasya paramanandaha. This is the most exalted ananda or happiness for the jiva. Hyetasyeva anandasya anyaya bhutani matram upajivanti, says Brihadaranyaka Upanishad, that all the beings only partake of a small fraction of the ananda, that is Brahman. So of this Brahmananda, all the beings only partake of a very fraction. As we said the other day, from the last verse of the Manisha Panchakam, that's where what Shankaracharya says, that who is the wise man? So one, first of all he describes the ananda, which is nothing but the ocean, and all these chakradaya, all these devatas such as Indra, etc., are also nothing but experience just a fraction of the ananda. And so anywhere anybody experiences any happiness, there is nothing but a fraction of the happiness that is Brahma. And that's what this verse says, eshahasya paramanandaha. This Brahmananda is indeed Param ananda, the ananda of the limitless happiness. Yah akhandaikarasatmakaha. So that which is indivisible, ekarasatma, homogeneous, the non-dual, indivisible, homogeneous ananda, that is the param ananda, is the limitless happiness of this jiva, of anyone. Anyani bhutani etasya matramim upabhunjade. And all the rest of the beings, they experience merely or enjoy merely a fraction of this ananda. So this is what the Upanishad itself says, that anybody experiencing any happiness anywhere is nothing but a fraction of Brahmananda. Meaning thereby that Brahma is only a source of ananda, and that alone is experienced by everybody. So we, even when you listen to music and experience happiness, you are experiencing Brahma. And eating good food, you experience happiness, again experience of Brahma. Looking at the flowers, you are happy, again experience of Brahma. A good thought and you are happy, experience of Brahma. Somebody told you a nice word and you are happy, experience of Brahma. Anyway, in any manner, whenever you experience happiness, you are only experiencing Brahma alone. Except that, whatever be the clarity of the mind, it reflects Brahman. So to the extent that the mind is clear, to that extent we experience a greater and greater intensity of happiness. And this is what the author wants to say. Idanim Vishayanandasya Brahmanandaleshattva Pradarshanaya. Now author wants to show how the Vishayananda or the Ananda of the sense object is a fraction of the Brahmananda. That's what he wants to show in this chapter. Thereby saying that if you understand Vishayananda, then also you understand Brahmananda. Because Vishayananda is nothing but a fraction of Brahmananda. So that's the point he wants to make. In order to do that, tadupadhibhuta antahkarnavrutti vibhajate. So, that instrument that is necessary in experience of any happiness, namely our mind. So, in the next two verses, the author in fact describes or divides the various thoughts of mind in three categories, which we are familiar with. Antahkarnavrutti vibhajate. He divides all the thoughts of the mind in three categories in the next two verses.
Shanta ghorastatha mudhaha, shanta ghorastatha mudhaha, manaso vrittayastridha, manaso vrittayastridha, vairagyam kshanti raudaryam, vairagyam kshanti raudaryam, ityadya shanta vrittayah, ityadya shanta vrittayah. तृष्णास्नेहोरागलोभौ इत्याद्याघोरवृत्तयः सम्मोहोभयमित्याद्याः कथितामूढवृत्तयः. Shantaha, ghuraha, tatha mudaha, manasaha, vrittayah, tridha.
Manasaha, vrittayah. The various thoughts of the mind, tridha, are threefold. So various thoughts of the mind can be divided into these three categories. What are the categories? Shantaha, the tranquil thoughts. Ghuraha, the agitated thoughts. Mudaha, the dull thoughts. So all the various thoughts of the mind can be divided into these three categories. Shantaha, the tranquil, sattvik ke vritte hai. All these sattvik, you know very well, that the disposition of the mind are looked upon as sattva, rajas and tamas. So mind is a combination of these three gunas, sattva, rajas and tamas. Tamas means dullness. So therefore, when the mind is sattvic, the vritti of the thought form is tranquil. When the mind is rajas, the thought is agitated. When the mind is tamas, the thought is dull. Okay, then what are the examples? Taya shanta di vritti hi darshari. Then the author illustrates, what are these thoughts? Vairagyam kshanti raudaryam ityadyaha shanta vrittayah. Vairagyam, dispassion. What is vairagyam? Freedom from raga and dvesha. Raga is rajoguna, dvesha is tamoguna. Vairagyam, a state of mind that is free from these passions of attachments and aversion. So attachment represents agitation and aversion represents the dullness. So when the mind is free from attachment and aversion, then the mind is sattvic. So that's called vairagyam, a state of dispassion. Kshantihi, kshanti means what? Forgiveness, accommodation, compassion. So kshanti is forgiveness or accommodation. This accommodation is possible only when again my mind is accommodative. Which mind can accommodate? That which is like space, accommodative, which is clear, which is pure, which is free. So when the mind is agitated, I am not accommodative. When mind is dull, I am not accommodative. When can I be accommodative? When the mind is tranquil. Audaryam, that means generosity, compassion, kindness. So dispassion and forgiveness, accommodation, kindness, compassion, all of these are thoughts fall in the category of shanta vrittayah, meaning the thoughts that arise from sattva guna. Trishna sneho ragalobho ityadyaha ghor vrittayah. What are the ghor vrittis? That's why he said agore bhyo thagore bhyo
ghora ghora tarebhyah. So Lord Shiva has these three forms. Aghorebhyah, those who are ghora. Asa ghorebhyah, those who are ghora. Ghora ghora tarebhyah, one is ghora ghora tara. Ghora means what? Agitated. That is aghora. Aghora means free from agitation, sattvic. So our salutations to Lord Lakshana with the Lord Shiva, who is sattvic. Asa ghorebhyah. Also our salutation to Lord Shiva, who is ghora, who is, you know, who is ferocious. Ghora ghora tarebhyah is most ferocious. So who is agitated or active, let us say. And ghora ghora tarebhyah, our salutation to the Lord Shiva is most ferocious. There are three forms of Shiva. The benign form, Dakshinamurti, the kind, compassionate, auspicious. The active form, the creator, you know, that's the active form. And destroyer, the most ferocious form. So our salutations to Lord Shiva, who has these three forms. So Shanta Vritya means Aghora Vritya hai. Second way is our Ghora Vritya hai. And third are Ghora Ghora Vritya hai. Satrishna, Sneha hai, Raga Lobhau, Ityadyaha, Ghora Vritya hai. Trishna, Trishna means craving. The craving is like fire, that is, when you fulfill the desire, then it keeps on increasing. So that craving is also is ghora vritti. Sneha, attachment, is ghora vritti. Sympathetic reaction, you know. So when somebody is happy, I am happy. Somebody is unhappy, I am unhappy. This kind of a thing is called sneha, attachment. Raga lobha, raga means attraction, attachment. Lobha, lobha means the greed. All of these are called vrittis born of rajoguna, ghora vrittis. Sammoha, bhayam, ityadyaha, kathitaha, mood vrittaya. Where is sammoha? Sammoha means what? Delusion. Delusion meaning judging things wrongly. Seeing something which is not there. Seeing the evil which is not there. Or seeing good which is not there. Both are sammoha. So when passion arises in me, I see the greatness where it is not there. And where anger or resentment arises in me, I see the evil which is also not there. And so that is called sammoha. A state of mind where it sees the thing which is not there or imposes thing which is not there. Bhayam and fear, so all these are called vrittis or the thoughts born of tamas. Ityadyaha, kathitaha, mood vrittaya. So these are called mood vrittis. So vrittis born of tamas. There is something common in all the vrittis and something this special also. Udahurtasu vidhasu vivrittisu brahmana chidrupatvam bhati iti. And in all these vrittis, the sat and chit of brahma, sat and chit aspect of brahma, it shines in all the three vrittis. And brahman is and brahman shines, so the sattvic, rajas and tamas, all these vrittis reveal the sat and chit aspect of brahma, but not ananda aspect. The ananda is revealed, or happiness at Brahman is revealed only by in the sattvic vritti. That is what I said in the next verse. Vrittishvetasu sarvasu, vrittishvetasu sarvasu, brahmanaschit svabhavata, pratibimbati shantasu, pratibimbati shantasu, sukham cha pratibimbade, sukham cha pratibimbade. Vrittishu etasu sarvasu, etasu sarvasu vrittishu, vrittishu. In all these various thoughts, whether sattvic, rajas or tamas, brahmana chit svabhavata pratibimbade. Chit svabhavata, that brahman is chit or awareness, consciousness, that pratibimbade, it gets reflected. This consciousness that Brahman is, that gets reflected in all these thoughts. Meaning, these thoughts, whatever they are, they do not obstruct Brahman, that is existence, because they reflect existence. They do not obstruct Brahman, that is awareness. They reflect Brahman, that is awareness. But the rajas and tamas vrittis do reflect, do obstruct the happiness that Brahman is. So happiness or ananda that Brahman is,
is only reflected in what? Shantasu sukham cha pratibimbade. So that is a vishesha, some distinction that the sattvic vritti enjoys, that in that vritti, brahmanah sukham cha pratibimbade. Cha meaning that in shanta vritti, in a sattvic vritti, meaning when the mind is tranquil. So when the mind is agitated, or the mind is angry or dull, then also this the sat and chit aspect of Brahma, they get reflected. They don't get obscured, but it is only when the mind is tranquil, that ananda that Brahman is, it gets reflected. Shantasu vrittishu sukham cha pratibimbade. In the thoughts which are shanta or tranquil, sattvic, even sukha or ananda that Brahman is also reflected. Where do you find that? Uptase Shruti Vakyam Arthadav Pasade. In order to support this, in the next verse, the author quotes a statement from Shruti Upanishad, Bhrodaranyaka and Katha Upanishad. Rupam Rupam Babhuvasau, Rupam Rupam Babhuvasau, Prati Rupaiti Shrutihi, Prati Rupaiti Shrutihi. उपमा सूर्य के इत्यादि उपमा सूर्य के इत्यादि सूत्रयामास सूत्रकृत सूत्रयामास सूत्रकृत रूपम रूपम बभुवासौ बभुवासौ प्रतिरूपः इति श्रुतिः. हाउ कैन यू से दैट ब्रह्मन गेट्स रिफ्लेक्टेड इन द थॉट्स? हाउ कैन यू से ब्रह्मन गेट्स रिफ्लेक्टेड इन एवरी थॉट? Because Brahman is non-undivisible, so cannot be divided. Indivisible, undivided, and indivisible. So how can Brahman, which is formless, how can it get reflected in every thought? So in order to support that every thought reflects Brahman, that is Sat and Chit, the author says here from Brihadaranyaka Upanishad and Katha Upanishad, Rupam Rupam Babhu Asau. Agni Jathaiko Bhuvanam Pravishtaha रूपम रूपम प्रतिरूपो बहुवा एकस्तथा सर्वभूतांतरात्मा रूपम रूपम प्रतिरूपम बहिश्च. सेज कठोपनिषद, जस्ट एज वन फायर एंटर्स द वेरियस कंबस्टिबल्स एंड टेक्स देयर फॉर्म्स. सो इन द फायर इफ देयर इज एन एम्बर विच इज ट्रायंगुलर, इफ द चारकोल इज ट्रायंगुलर, स्क्वायर, राउंड, व्हाटएवर बी द शेप ऑफ द चारकोल, दैट हैपेंस, दैट आल्सो बिकम्स द शेप ऑफ द फायर, बिकॉज़ fire also enters the charcoal and seems to assume the forms, and so also oneself, ekastatha sarvabhutandaratma, the self who is the indwelling self of all, rupam rupam pratirupo bahishcha, oneself enters all the beings and as though becomes of the nature of all the beings. In short, it is not that the atma gets divided, atma appears to get divided in association with all different upadis. So every upadi reflects the self and it looks as though the self is divided into so many beings. And the same thing is said in Brahma Sutra. And so in support of that, tatreva vyasa sutra ekadesham patati ataeva cha iti sutrasya purvabhaga. And in support of that, again the author quotes from Brahma Sutra. Upama suryaka ityadi sutrayamasa sutrakrita. Sutrakrita means what? One who composed Brahma Sutra. Who is it? Badarayana. Sutrayamasa. This is how he said in the aphorism. Atayavacha upama suryakadivata. Somebody asked a question. How do you say that Brahman appears as many? But the jivas are many, therefore we say that atmas are many. How can you say atma is one? We say atma is one. Atma is indivisible. How can Atma, who is one and indivisible, appear as many? Then the example is given, Upama Suryakadivata. The illustration is here, the reflection of the sun. Just as one sun, being reflected in many buckets of water, appears as many. Without becoming many, how one sun appears as many, and so also oneself, being reflected in all these upadis, appears as many. Not that it is many. So how one can appear as many? Similarly, as the various thoughts arise in the mind, every thought is comparable to a mirror, and that reflects Brahman. And therefore every thought, whether it is sattvic, rajas or tamas, reflects Brahman, which is sat and chit. And only the shanta vritti reflects the Brahman, that is ananda. Okay, we'll continue with this. Om Purnamadav Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti 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 Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Badarayanam Sutra Bhashya Krutau Vande Bhagavantau Punah Punah Ishvaro Guru Ratmedi Murti Bheda Vibhagine Vyomavad Vyapta Dehaya Dakshina Murtaye Namah Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Hari Om.